Hey, you guys. Happy Mother's Day. From my sister's family. Look at this. A giant cookie. It smells like, you know, one of those sugar cookies for Christmas time. Isn't that pretty? Sushi, and I just thought of a good story time I could tell you guys. One I'm sure I've never shared before. I may have mentioned it, but since it's Mother's Day, maybe we can all relate. Either us as mothers, or you may know someone who might fit in this category. But do you ever look at people, or you see older people and then you see pictures of them in their youth, and they were on the track team, they did all these things that you would just never guess was part of their life, because obviously now they're in their golden years, 60, 70, 80, 90 years old, and perhaps not as active. I think perhaps I'm in that category. I mentioned it very briefly the other day in my secret fix number 2 video. I always think of this, and not sure what the answer would be, but I try to think of myself, what would I be today had I not gotten married and had children? And I always joke to the family about I'd probably be like a Madonna, or I'd be some kind of rock and roll star, because I'm so addicted to music and singing and karaoke. And that's something that always is pops up first in my mind, and I'd be like a famous rock and roller in my dreams, right? But which sparkling ice is this? This is fruit punch. Very nice. I like it. So I may have mentioned that in high school, my mom and I, first gym I ever went to was Venus de Milo. Back in the mid, late 70s. And I've always been a sports person my whole life. I've always been a tomboy. And never been to a gym. And at that time, our neighbor, he was a gym fanatic, also a single guy living with our neighbors, but he knew how much I loved playing sports and mentioned that I should go to the gym and it would really improve my sports game. I did all the sports, volleyball, basketball, softball. And I pretty much poo-pooed the idea. It did not sound fun to me. So I'm thinking of going in with these barbells and you're just lifting weight. Well, boy, was I wrong. Now, all the neighbor talked about was free weights. When I went to Venus de Milo and saw they had all these machines, my whole world turned around. I was immediately addicted, did very well, and carried that gym addiction that began with my mom and the eating and the vitamins. It was a whole packaged plan for me. Exercise, eating right, and supplementing. We might be needing, at that time, they just supplemented with the B and C vitamins. So, my life goes on. So, in 1979, I moved to Santa Barbara. I had my own apartment. I'm living the happy, that girl life. Remember that girl? A young, single girl in an apartment, supporting herself. That was me at age 19, in downtown Santa Barbara. Two-bedroom, two-bath apartment for like $250. Crazy cheap. I was like right next to Cottage Hospital. After like a 2-month stint in Isla Vista, but we could talk, that's a whole nother story for a whole nother video too, if you're familiar with Isla Vista. But anyways, so I know people slam the post office, but because of that job, I had the best start in life as a young person. I was able to do so many things. I had 2 cars, wonderful apartment. It was just wonderful in Santa Barbara. Just a wonderful beginning. So I get hooked up with the YMCA down by the San Roque. I think it was called the San Roque Mall or Plaza. It had a Robinson's and a Sears. It was somewhere near there. Oh my goodness. All they had was Nautilus. I'm telling you, I was the Nautilus queen. And I went to the gym every day, to the machines every day. And before I did the machines, I had my little stretching routine that I did in the stretching room before I did my machines. And my grocery bill each week was $25, and a big fancy week was $35. And I remember my shopping list: non-fat milk, chicken, popcorn, butter, bread, and mayo. And I'd throw in maybe some diet soda. And my regimen was I was strict all week with eating. And weekends, I just ate normal. Go out and eat. And a lot of fast food. A lot of Taco Bell. I'll never forget. A ton of Taco Bell. And a ton of Burger King. And so that was 1979, and that continued up until about 10 years ago. And then I think I may have just grown up. My schedule changed, I changed, my body changed, my mental attitude changed. It seemed as if my body and brain was saying, okay, it's time to take a break. Just like when I was 30, I ran a half marathon. I wanted to do something special at age 30, and for me, it was running a half marathon. So then after I did that, it was like this huge thing I wanted to achieve. Life, the Lompoc half marathon. I never jogged again after that. It was like I did it. Okay, the thrill is gone, so I'm gonna move on. So I did. And that was 30 years ago. I did continue the gym up until about 10 years ago. And always like the thought. People would ask me if I was a bodybuilder. And I didn't even have like the super skinny bikini type body you could have to be a bodybuilder. I said no. I was very critical. I guess because I wasn't skinny. I never thought of being a bodybuilder, but others did. Plus, I did not, think the female bodybuilders were all that. That was too much. I didn't strive for my body to look like that. It just did not look nice. And I thought of how do I want my body to look? It wasn't like that. But anyway, I'm probably a big climax end to where I felt I really made it to the top was about 10 years ago. Maybe it was 11. Maybe this was the event that made me think, okay, I can stop now. My husband and I were at Venice Beach. If you're familiar with Venice Beach, there's Muscle Beach, and there's the gym right there. Venice Beach. Schwarzenegger worked out there, the whole nine yards. Super famous Muscle Beach. And bigger than beans, they were having a female competition bodybuilder event that weekend, and we didn't know. So I walk up to the table, my husband and I were walking, and I said, oh, wait, I want to go see what they're doing over here. I plowed over to the desk, and there's a guy sitting there, and I had on a t-shirt, like a cute white t-shirt and cute jean shorts, and trying to get information, and he immediately takes out his iPhone, his phone, flip. Back then it was a flip phone. I says, great legs. Do you mind? I want to take a picture. I said, oh. I didn't even say yes or no, but he took a picture. And that was a little stressful, but I just wanted to see what was happening today. And he says, oh, so you're not here to participate. I said, no. So I'm wondering if that was the moment that made me think, I've arrived, and I don't need, am I doing all this exercise for myself? Am I trying to achieve something? But it just seems like a year or two after that was when, you know, my life just, everything changed. So anyways, that's my Mother's Day story time, true story time. And there's lots of times I think of what would my life have been had I not been married with a husband and mom with kids. And somehow I just tend to believe I'd be on my same path, being a karaoke rock and roll star and to be a diehard gym fanatic. As you see, I still take my supplements. That hasn't stopped, but happy Mother's Day.